HST.725 is a course really aimed at surveying music perception and cognition. Much of our curriculum nowadays in neuroscience and biology and psychology is very specialized. We look at very small problems, very compartmentalized problems. The knowledge is parcelized into very small pieces, and the big picture gets lost. So an important part, I think, of any pedagogy in any university really is to get students to think synthetically, to think about what is the nature of our auditory systems and our brains such that music has the effects that it does. So a typical class would be a lecture, and we had many demonstrations. I would often use my computer oscilloscope, would look at the structure of sounds. We used animations from the music animation machine to illustrate both the horizontal and vertical structure of music. We'd listen to musical pieces that illustrated particular aspects of music perception and cognition. I would talk for about an hour, going over the area, the topic of the day, which could be something like the perception of pitch or timbre or consonants or harmony or scene analysis and grouping processes, something like that. And the course was small enough so that we could have a back and forth, and many of the students, it's a graduate course, and we had some undergraduates also, but many of the students already were dealing with these issues in their own work. Well, it's a small elective course, and it was an experimental course, as I said, that we taught for the first time last spring. And what I wanted to do was to structure the course in a way that we would both systematically cover the perception and cognition of music, music psychology, but that would allow the students a great deal of freedom in choosing their own aspect of music psychology that they wanted to look into. So the main work that the students do is their own term project, and that can be a review paper that covers extensively some area of music perception and cognition. It can be an experimental project where students can go and actually do experiments or surveys in psychology of music. Or it could be a music project, a music composition that illustrates the principles of music perception, talks about those. Or a simulation or a model, scientific model, that illuminates and explores some aspect of the mechanisms that are involved. So the bulk of the student work in this case was a term project. We also had an oral presentation that students gave on a paper that they chose in the course, and we also had a large problem set and take-home test. And what I had in mind was to systematically look at auditory perception and auditory cognition with music as the object of that perception and cognition. So the intention is very much kind of in the spirit of Hermann von Helmholtz's On the Sensations of Tone as a basis for a psychology of music, in that spirit, to systematically go through, look at the structure of the musical stimulus, the structure of music as a sound object, and then look at the perception. How do we perceive music? What are the qualities of the sounds that we hear? How do they interact? And then look at the underlying neural representations and computations that allow us to apprehend that structure and appreciate it.